Hi, this is Russ Andersson. In this tutorial, we're going to be doing a little tracking and solving in SynthEyes and then exporting to After Effects using lens workflow number one, where you're delivering a shot that has no distortion in it. So we're going to start out just running the auto tracker on the shot to generate some tracking marks, and we're going to just scrub through, and there are a bunch of people walking around in the foreground, so I'm just going to take them out first so that they don't cause any trouble. So it's always just a good idea to get rid of things that you know are going to be problems that you see, and SynthEyes will drop bunch of them automatically, but it's a better idea just to take them out first. So now let's flip over to the solver panel. We're going to be calculating distortion, so we'll have it do that, and we'll fire up the solver so that we get a 3D solve for the shot. And at this point, let's go and do a little tracker cleanup. So it just goes and it identifies a bunch of the trackers that are problematic. And actually, one of the things that would have been clever here, let's just stop this, is that we've got a bunch of trackers out in the clouds, and those really aren't contributing anything useful. One of the benefits of waiting to this point in this case is just that we had the tracking marks to be able to locate them all easily without having to do much in the way of scrubbing. So let's just run through that again. And now let's run the tracker cleanup. Now there are just a couple down there. It looks like one of them might have been a person walking around. So we'll just update that solve. And now we've got our basic solve. And, you know, SynthEyes is computed the distortion on that. You can see what a distorted version of the grid looks like. It's got a bunch of pincushion distortion on it. So if we wanted, we could just go and export to After Effects now, and I'm going to tell you that that's not the greatest idea, and let's just take a look at why. So we've got After Effects ready to load the scene up. And there we have it. That's just using the run immediate feature of that exporter. And you know, if you look up here, you can see that the shot imagery has been distorted to compensate so that everything is a linear camera. And the way that that was done was SynthEyes called up a distortion effect on the footage. But, you know, you can see that there's some black boundaries around the outside, and that's not going to be very good to deliver to a client as is. So really what we wanted to be doing is, instead of exporting immediately, we want to go back here to the summary panel and fire up the lens workflow script. And it gives you two choices for depending on what you want to deliver. And as I said originally, we're going to be delivering undistorted footage. So we're going to fire up this first option here and run the workflow script. And you just saw it kind of zoomed in a little bit. And that was just enough so that the shot, now when we export it, you know, won't have any of the black boundary. And you see that here, where there's no longer any of the boundary around the outside. So that is the purpose of that script. It's always going to go and adjust so that you have a full frame here, an undistorted version of the imagery. Now, you can see that it's a bit on the laggy side here in After Effects because we have all these trackers sitting around. So let's go back to SynthEyes, and what we'll do just for fun is we'll take that one tracker up at the top, and we'll make that be the only one that we export. So I'm going to do a Control I to invert the selection, turn off the exportable checkbox down there, and do the Control I again. Now I'm going to do a Shift X. And now there's just that one that's being exported. And so at this point, let's just do something fun. And I'm just bringing in a little piece of stock footage. And we'll drop that down into the comp with a little luck. And we'll change that to be a 3D piece of footage. Let's just immediately go and fix up the keying. And now what we're going to do is drop it up on top of that torch up there. So we're going to just go and zero out the position offset. And we're going to reparent it to our tracker. And you'll see there's a little white thing that's being produced by After Effects telling you what the options are. We're going to hold down the Alt so that we want it to jump. And now it's sitting up there. You can adjust the size a bit. And now let's just zoom in a little bit. Now I can use the anchor points. To adjust the spot. So, you know, what we've done is made the flag line up exactly with that tracker point, but now we're just adjusting the relative positioning a little. So now we've got our flag waving up there. And of course is a now you get to the compositing part of this. And we want to fix up the levels there that are definitely too hot. And probably we'd want to add a little blur to it also, just so that it doesn't look too computer-generated sharp. Probably want to zoom in to to adjust that exactly. So here's a quick use of the SynthEyes tracking and export to After Effects using lens distortion and the first workflow. And this comp now is what we would write out and send off to the client. So thanks for watching. Now be sure to check out the matching tutorial that shows the second workflow as well. Thanks.